What's up, Mercs? It's Young here with some more Fallout Frost. Last we found the Roadside Pines Motel, and today we're gonna look around, so let's get a move on. Now, I think for the most part, we have looted everything there is to loot last time. We can go check on the roof here, but yeah, it looks like it's just some sort of a lookout point. So for the most part, we're pretty much done with the motel itself. Now, there is this little section of town, and I am seeing some campfires over there. So there might be someone living over there that we might need to deal with. There was a lot of mites right there, but that's okay. Let's go ahead and drink some of our purified water just to go ahead and get our thirst under control. Ooh, we need two, it looks like. Yep, there we go. All right, our thirst is good. Now, again, I don't want to take any alcohol because, remember, I want to make sure I only drink whiskey, if anything, because we're going to be getting rid of our alcohol addiction quite soon. In fact, I wouldn't mind getting rid of it right now. Do we have any other whiskey in our inventory? No. We're out of alcohol. We've used what we need to use. So in that case, there we go. We are no longer addicted to alcohol. Wow, that feels good. That has been a long time coming. Natick Banks. Okay, so this is a pretty big town, actually. I didn't notice all the buildings. So what I'm going to do real quick is player.getAVAA sanity. Our sanity is negative 92 without the addiction. Still really, really high in the negatives, but, you know, it might be able to be taken care of. Also, I just heard snarling. Don't know where that came... Okay, something keeps snarling at me. Oh! It's a dog. Hi, puppers. Hello. Okay, you want to come out the window? No? Okay. There we go. Let's see how many more are living here, if any. It looks like it was just one dog just kind of foraging for food, unfortunately, for him. Well, whatever. I don't think we're going to find too much in here. This place looks pretty ransacked, although there is a second floor. So maybe? Bottle cap in the washer? That's not bad. Antique globe, some dead people, yeah, military-grade duct tape. That's not bad, but right now I'm not really looking for much anyway. Oh, can I not get up? Okay, yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything up there anyway. And it's blocked off by a little bit of wood, so whatever. All right, and looks like we had a doghouse here. Maybe this was that dog's home. I doubt it, but you never know. We got a church, and from the looks of it on the compass, I did see some sort of police station. So that's going to be interesting. Also, we have a barricade, which means there's a base here. That's a Deathclaw. There's a Deathclaw here. There is a Deathclaw right in here. Yep. It's right there. Hi. Yeah. All right. Well, we'll take it slow. We'll take it easy. But I'm still going to loot this area. I'm not just going to run away. I can't leave an entire town unlooted like that. That would not bode well for me at all. So we'll see what I can find without having to aggro the evil Mr. Deathclaw. Also, how far south are we? We're not gonna, like... Okay, I think we're fine. Yeah, because... Okay. I don't want to accidentally, like, run into the glowing sea without even realizing it and killing myself. That would be awkward. Got some money in there. So it looks like we have some sort of cafe. What is that? Luxabrew coffee pot. I thought it was something more unique. Whoa. Looks like there was a sinkhole or some sort of landslide that made all the buildings fall in. Also, it looks to me like the survivor camp that I said was here. Oh, bourbon. You were great at one time, but not anymore. The survivor camp that I said was here, it looks like that was actually destroyed by the Deathclaw. At least from the looks of it. Ooh, got a Vault-Tec lunchbox. Nice. In all honesty, hang on, let me just... There we go. Wanted to move my keyboard down a little bit. I can probably take out that Deathclaw from here using my sniper rifles and stuff. So let's just start opening fire on it. Because as long as it's down there, we should be fine. It's not gonna... Oh. Or, you know, that works too. Yeah, that works. You just gonna stay down there, buddy? Yeah, I don't think he can find his way back up. Is there anything I can throw at him, maybe? Just in case. Nuke a grenade. I don't really want to use a nuke grenade on him. Got a plasma mine. Can I get that down there? Not quite. Well, He's just gonna be stuck down there, because I don't think he understands how to get back up. So, looks like we're pretty good. That wasn't my plan, but I'm not going to argue with that. Let's go ahead and close that, and it looks... Okay, that was the gate that scared the shit out of me. I thought the death claw came back up. Alright, well, it looks like we have this whole place to ourselves now. That was, honestly, not as hard as I was expecting it to be. They didn't even have to use that much ammunition. Just had to piss him off enough to kill himself, basically. Or to jump off a cliff and get himself stuck. Some wine, there's some bottles laying around. What's my carry weight at? 164, 165. I'm now overtired. That's not good. I don't want to sleep here, though. Because I have a feeling if I sleep here, there's a good chance that Deathclaw might find its way back up here eventually, and I might wake up to it just standing there. I'd rather not, so... Yeah, I'm not gonna bother. Not yet, at least. We still have enough carry weight to actually move around, which is the main thing. And, well, we can mark things with our minds, and we have to come back for them after we sleep.
That's it.
Berry Mentats and Mentats. Good, good, good. I could just start chomping down on all my positive sanity-giving drugs if I really wanted to, but... I don't know about that. I don't think that's the best idea right now, because we just don't have enough water. If I had a lot more water, I would. If I had more carry weight, I'd be getting more water, but... Yeah, it's just a whole kind of problem right now. This is the one bad thing about not being able to drink alcohol all the time. We're going to lose that strength benefit. Although, if we do level our strength up to 10, alcohol will never give us strength benefits again, you know? Because our strength will be at max. Interesting thing to think about, but that seems like some waste of perk points, if you ask me. Got some ammo, though. Nice, happy with that. And just looking for traps as I go. Looks like someone might be dead up here. There's bloody handprints as we go up. Hello? Maybe they crawled away from the death claw and they just bled out up here somewhere? I don't know. Maybe not. I don't see any bodies. Damn, I really wanted to loot someone. Get some more ammo. Let's do the safe thing and just run across this extremely narrow beam just to get $5 worth of cloth. Not bad, not bad. I do like taking risks. It is how I run.
Nice.
Gold watch. No, I'm good. And let's see if there's anyone up here. Again, look for mines as I go up. There's a tree. There's no bodies, though. Alright. Well, for the most part, this is clear, then. Let's get over to that police station and see if we can't find anything in there. This isn't the most loot-heavy town, but I would imagine it's because, well, anything that was here is probably gone because, well, no one's really living here anymore. At least, no one who's alive. Unless you count the Deathclaw, but... Who counts death claws? They're not living things, they're monsters! But I guess that means they're living. Whatever. Oh, hello. Oh, almost missed that one. Oh, all right, nicely done. I'm gonna drop actually just one of those so I can carry it with me. I'm actually surprised I spotted it. Hey, he's back! Oh, no! Son of a bitch. He figured it out. Okay. Alright, well, at least we looted everything we had to in there. Let's go to the police station. Actually, let's check this red rocket out first. Fuck me, dude. That death claw could tear me to shreds in like a heartbeat. Okay, I just want to be cautious in here because it was glowing green. Didn't want a glowing one to just come out and try and kill me. I think we're good, though. Probably got money in here, yeah. A few dollar, or a few $10 bills, 12 of them. It's a decent amount of cloth. I need to get back to the Metro Federation, like, soon, so I use some trading. Don't want to head south anymore, because as you can see, it's starting to turn to the glowing wasteland, or the glowing sea. The farther south you go, the more radiation you're going to get, and eventually we'll just die, so I don't even want to go near that. We don't need a repeat of what happened last time when I tried the glowing sea. But, I think, see, I said I didn't want to head back to the city, but I kind of want to head... Oh, I don't want to fall and die here. I kinda do wanna head back to the Metro Federation. No, we'll do it after I go to the recon bunker. I really wanna go to the recon bunker first. Natick Police Department. Book return machine? In the middle of nowhere. Maybe something good? Oh, do I have any books to return? Yes. Oh no, I didn't. Toy cars, scissors, nothing good. Damn. I know there's some machines that have, like, stim packs, but they're extremely, extremely rare machines. Wow, this place got completely destroyed. We have an evidence terminal. Anything? Intoxication, breaking and entering, tire iron, bag, shattered glass, set of fingerprint, eh. Okay. Well, where was the evidence locker? Gotta be really careful here. I don't want to accidentally slip off and die. Ooh, anything in here? Nope. They left it empty. What do we got? Silver tablespoon. Let's hop across here. The holding cells are beneath us, so that could be close to where the evidence lockup is. Let's go ahead and check that out. This looks like it was maybe the equipment room, maybe not the evidence locker, but I don't know. Maybe that was the evidence locker. And yeah, doesn't look like there's anything really in here except for an overdue book, which I can go ahead and return real quick. Wow, we're actually pretty low to the water there. Come on, get there before my AP runs out. Bam. Perfect. All right, let's return. Yes, there we go. Then we can walk again. Yeah, it looks like there's really nothing else in here. That's unfortunate. But I mean, what can you expect from a police station that's falling off the hill into a lake instead of an ocean? Whatever. Let's get out of here. Let's head south, or north, I mean. We have cleared this place out for the most part. There's nothing else I really want here, or that I think I can find here. Turn that light off. Sneak by him. I wonder if there are two death claws, or did he really get his way back up? Oh, fuck. No, there's only one. He found his way back up. Actually, I want to go back down there then and take that plasma line back. If I can find it. Also, I would like to loot this building. Hmm. Hello. Ugh. Can I vats maybe? There it is. I wanted to vats and see if I can't get it. Alright, it's underneath the house. See if I can't get over there to it. It's really steep here, but it's like right here somewhere. There it is. Alright, we are carrying too much, so we do need to drop something. Go to junk and see what I can get here. Bandage, scissors, adjustable wrench. That's something I don't need right now. Alright, we're good to go. Let's head north and then start going to the recon bunker. We'll follow the river up, we'll try and avoid Fort Hagen, which shouldn't be too hard, considering it's not really close to the river at all. I think the first thing we're going to do, though, is sleep. Because we're in a relatively safe spot, so let's go ahead and sleep for 5 hours. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to sleep for 5 hours. And hopefully we won't be overtired at that point. We shouldn't be. So another 5 hours. This should get us into daytime, too, which is always nice to see. Yep, good, no storm, no nothing. Just nice. A little bit snowy, but I did not mean to take psychotats. But that does lower my sanity. It actually, yeah, it does lower my sanity. I thought it raised sanity, but no, it doesn't. Fuck. Shit. That's
fucking
okay.
Kill!
No, no, no. Don't fucking kill. Calm down. Don't worry. We're not fighting right now. Bit of a waste of psychotats, but honestly, I probably won't ever be using them anyway. Because Psychojet's just 10 million times better. In fact, Psychotats is probably one of the worst things you could ever make. And the reason for that, we have 170 now. Yeah, give me these beer bottles. The reason for that is because it takes away the sanity positive of Mentats. I think I've explained that before, though. But if I have, who cares? I always explain things more than once because that's just how I am. My memory's bad. What do you expect? Oh my Jesus fucking Christ. Oh god. Fuck. Okay. All right, we're good. I was not expecting that. All right. Ugh, fuck me. Alright, well, we can check this industrial building out. I forgot this was here, actually. It is something I saw when I was coming up to Nautic, though. Oh, we got some ghouls laying around here. There's one. Okay, we are found. Behind us. Hop up here. Oh, it's a festering, too. It's the Poseidon Reservoir. Oh, he did hit me, and yeah, he is festering, indeed. Fuck. And I leveled up. Nice. That is level 30. You know what that means. Bum-ba-da. Strong back. 4. Plus 20. 20 carry weight. We are so fucking nice now. 20 carry weight, boys. 20. 2-0. Sexy. Poseidon Reservoir. Okay, so we're probably gonna be ghoul infested. I mean, obviously. Hello, everybody. Yeah, just keep walking really slow so I can get some easy headshots, please. It really helps me out. I guess I'll take the industrial solvent. I think that has, what does industrial solvent have? I think it's antiseptic, right? Yep. Well, it's antiseptic. Good. Good, good, good. And what about you? Some money? Alright. Let's get up to the roof. Check the roof real quick, see if I can't clear any ghouls off there. And then, we'll head inside and see what we can't find to loot. Holy fuck. Shit. Okay, that's a festering. Wait, no, he's gone. He didn't. Actually, that is, though. Yeah, he's dead. It's like the worst place to attack ghouls, underneath them. Because it's hard to hit him in the head. Overall, though, it didn't go too bad. I mean, we hardly took any radiation. I mean, it'll build up after time, but, you know, we're doing pretty good, honestly. We got, I mean, it's not like we've been sneaking around good, and... Well, we didn't get hit by every single ghoul. I did some decent kills, so whatever, we're fine. I'd say overall, this is an average loot. Or adventure? I don't even know. And we didn't really loot that much, so I can't really call it a loot, can I? The fuck's a loot, anyway? Is that a new thing? Hello? No? Okay. Well, looks pretty clear. There might be a way into the building from the roof here. It's possible. I'm not sure, though. Let's head up first. And then we'll head over in that direction and see if there's anything over there. It probably just goes back down over there. Are you alive? No. Probably should have checked that with a gun, but, you know, whatever. I'm living life on the edge. It's just how I am. Also, dead people. 308 round, bandage, a night vision 50 pipe bolt action rifle. That's not very good because we have a much better rifle. That's 50 cal. Wow, he looked at me. That's creepy as fuck. Get out of here, bud. No, no, all the way. Oh, there you go. Goodbye. Okay, your friend's a little bit too heavy. I'm not even going to bother. All right, let's hop down here and see what else there is to see. Yeah, it looks like it just goes back down, maybe? Unless there's a doorway over on this little platform. Doesn't look like it, though. Let me just see. Does this go anywhere? No. And what about over here? Looks like maybe it's just like a platform to repair pipes if you need to, or maintenance and all that. Yeah. Alright. Whatever. Let's just hop down. And then let's go in the front door and let's see how many ghouls' heads we can crack. Load our pipe rifle. In we go! The Poseidon Reservoir. You know, it seems like it's gonna be ghouls, but my luck, it's gonna be like 6 death claws! Shit. Alright, slow. Oh, great. That was good. That was real good, Jono. Okay, I don't want him to, like, trigger it from underneath and then kill me by accident. Oh, hi! Oh, really? You actually got a hit off? Okay, well, that didn't even kill anyone. Oh, yeah, it did. Good. I don't know if it killed a lot of them, but hopefully it killed a lot. Wow, you do a lot of radiation damage. Holy shit. You're a festering. I might die here. Alright, well, that's a lot of festering. But I killed them all. Holy shit. I'm alive. Alright. Alright, alright. Good thing we have a lot of fungal purge. Let's start purging our fucking system here. Whew. Alright, that didn't go so bad. Could have went worse. I could have blocked a little bit better, but whatever, it's fine.
Sweet.
Purified water, stim pack, very nice. Radex. A nocturnal combat rifle? Now, the increased amount of damage as the night grows longer and less damage during the day. If it didn't have the less damage during the day, if it was just like, you know, gets more damage at night, I'd probably take it, but I kind of fight 50-50. Even though I have a, a night vision scope and everything, I don't really want to use that. I don't like having that kind of conditional effect on my gun. Unless it was just like a flat bonus half the time, that would be nice. Fuck me. That's a broken arm. Okay, let's go ahead and take a surgical kit here. Fuck, I wanted to kill the professor before he hit me. Oh, it's not even a professor. Hit him in the head! There we go. Oh, man, the radiation here. It's getting ridiculous. Ooh, solvent. Nice. Nice! Alright, another fungal purge, please. Let's bandage up a little more. Crap. There's a bomb in the back there. I don't really want it, though. See, the problem is... Oh, there's gas here, too. I can't really... Ooh, dirty water. Yes, please. I can't really use drugs as much right now because we're so low on water, and that makes you thirsty. If I had, like, 20 purified, I'd just be using jet all the fucking time and just, you know... Headshot, headshot, headshot! You know, like I always like to do with these things. But... It's not really the easiest thing to do when you don't have that much drink on hand. Oh, let's check the... Yeah, there we go. Tool case, please. Thank you. Oh, come on. There we go. Don't break it on a novice again. Alright, just an adjustable wrench. I kind of figured it wasn't anything good, but you know. It's always nice to get a little bit of extra novice XP when I'm in the mood for it. Sometimes I don't feel like opening novice locks, like when there's empty ammo crates, just because I'm lazy as fuck. But, you know, whatever. If I'm not lazy, it's nice to get the extra XP. So, you know, let's keep that light on. Doesn't seem like it aggers them more than anything else, really. Oh shit, the wrong one, that needs to die. Do I have a plasma mine still? Yep. Well, didn't kill him, but that did. Ow! What the fuck? You son of a bitch! You're not supposed to be able to hit me from down there, you bastard! How dare you? Okay, fungal purge one has worn off. Let's go ahead and take another one so we can get two running at the same time again. I also have Radaway, but Radaway lowers your immunities, and I don't really want that right now. Also, I don't want to waste Radaway when I don't really need it. Radaway is definitely like the thing you need. It's like... If you really need anti-rad, it's your last resort, because you don't want to waste perfectly good Radaway on, you know, just anything, because Radaway's so rare. Master Lock! Alright, take our bets now. I'm gonna guess it's just going to be money, and maybe a gold watch. Let's see if I was correct.
Got it.
Oh, fuck! Oh, good, I'm happy I was wrong. It's actually good stuff. That's nice. That's actually surprising. I'm happy I was wrong about that, because then we actually get something that's useful. Alright, I think we're good to go. Let me go ahead and do a little bit of crafting here. I can't make any fungal purge because I'm out of glowing fungus, but that's okay. I haven't been picking any up, I know. But now that my carry weight's not really an issue, at least at the moment, I should be able to pick some up from now on. And we're good to go. I think that's basically everything in here. I'll take the irradiated blood, why not? I don't know why I take it. I don't really use it. I just think to myself, well, if I ever go to the Metro Federation, I'm pretty sure it sells for a decent amount, but probably won't be going there anyway. Yeah, we didn't check up here, did we? Hmm. Mentats! That's good. That's useful. Just fats a little bit, make sure nothing goes off in my face. And it looks just like a boring no-loot area. New toy car, though. Hmm. Ooh, an expert tool case! Now that's interesting. It's probably just gonna be a tool, but you never know. It is an expert lock. Is it worth it, or is it not? Let's see. Was it worth it?
Yes.
Ah, turpentine. Maybe, I guess. I don't know. Guess there wasn't really a negative of not doing it, or of doing it, you know, except for losing one bobby pin because I fucked it up back there, but whatever.
That's it.
And that's pretty useless. I mean, you know, the gears and stuff, that's nice, but eh. Don't really need it. Okay, so let's go ahead and throw down our sleeping bag. Let's save. I need to find somewhere to cook. Unfortunately, I cannot use my cooking pot because I don't have a cooking... I don't have a campfire kit. I don't have the wood right now to make one. Granted, if I looked around here, I might be able to find the wood for it, but I don't feel like looking around for wood. I'm not in dire need of water right now, so we're fine. I'm not even gonna bother right now. Campfire kits, man, I need like a few of them on hand at all times, like two at least, but I just don't feel like looking for wood ever, because I never think to pick wood up, because it's never really useful any other time. But, no, whatever. We'll find a cooking spot soon enough. Looks like... What is this? It's like a giant pipe? What is this thing? I'm curious. No, it's a tanker. It's a weird-looking tanker. Huh. Yeah, that's a tank, though. I guess. I would assume that's carrying some sort of liquid. I don't know, though. Where are we? Wow, we are far, far to the west. I guess I'll check up here in that case. Wait, is this Fort Hagen? This reminds me of Fort Hagen, this little building here. I don't think this is Fort Hagen. I think that's just the edge of the map. Yeah, this isn't Fort Hagen. Wait, is it? This is Fort Hagen. Not, this isn't, but we're close to it. But it would be nice to loot this little area. Right here? I don't have to go into Fort Hagen, but I can loot around it. As long as the vertebra doesn't take off and try and fuck me, I think we're fine. I think I can actually see Fort Hagen. I think that might be... it's close to Fort Hagen. Hello? Huh, power armor. Nice. Don't really use it, but nice. And rads. Great. What was that? What was that? Okay, I thought a giant rad roach dropped on my head for a second. I got really freaked the fuck out because I saw, like, legs, right? And I was, like, I was expecting to turn around and see, like, this massive fucking rad roach, and I was about to, like, squeal. That's why I turned around so slowly there, but we're good. We're good. I got really, really, really scared for a sec. Let's see. Got a little bit of an APC that's closed, unfortunately. Another one here. Looks like this used to be some sort of army outpost or something, but nothing really anymore. Good thing there's no one actually living here, or holding it, rather. Guess I can check this, might as well. Yeah, nothing. Alright, I think we're good to go. What kind of power was that? Was that T60? I don't want it anyway, because my carry weight will just go down because I don't have my backpack and stuff, but it's nice to look at. Yeah, it's T60. It's cool. This one actually doesn't have a fusion core, though. Wonder if it'll actually put one in when I get in it. Or if it'll just be out of power. Yeah, it's just out of power. Yeah. Interesting. An unpowered one. Maybe this place was abandoned. Doesn't seem like they were killed out of the area. It looks like they just left. Hang on. Ah, there we go. Had to crack my finger. Sometimes you get like a little cramp in your finger, and it's like you gotta crack it, man. Alright, we're getting relatively close to Fort Hagen. So I wanna be very careful, but there it is. I can see the vertebrae. There's something flying around too. You know what? Fuck it. There's a medical spot here, but no. I'm not even going near Fort Hagen. I can hear the vertebrae. Wait, that's a second vertebrae, because the first one is right there. Landed. I can hear a propeller right now of one that's in the air. So fuck that. I'm not even going near that place. Fort Hagen is just a mess of death and doom, and I don't even want to go near it. I don't want to deal with it. I don't want anything to do with it. So we'll just go past it. Yeah, here we go. I remember where we are now. This is where that thing exploded that we triggered. Okay. So straight north from here, and then... After straight north for a while, a very long while, straight east for a while, and then a little bit more north, and then we'll be at the recon bunker. I'm not gonna go north to the edge of the map and then east. I'm gonna go north to almost at the edge of the map, then east, so we can find some things along the way to the recon bunker, and then to the recon bunker. It looks like we're actually at the little, trailer park that we saw last time that was full of ghouls, so we gotta be careful. Do I wanna go in there? Yeah, I might as well loot it. So let's do that next time, because I think I'm going to end today's survival here. Hope you all enjoyed it, and I'll see you all next time. Of course, I'm getting my sleeping bag out real quick. Just to quickly do a little bit of a save. Goodbye.